I had completely not expected to make it to the finals of the contest. I never thought I had it in me. So all I wanted to do when I first participated was just, as long as one of the celebrity judges pressed the buzzer for me, I thought that would be validation enough.
In recent years, with bigger budget and better production quality, more people are watching programs made in China. Well, what do Singaporeans think about these programs?
I find Chinese program from China has improved leap and bound throughout these years. More and more that they are becoming more sophisticated.
Their production
他的音乐也挺不错的啦。So in an a cappella group, everybody uses their voices. So essentially any melody that I can sing, I can do a mouth trumpet with it. It's really that simple. Sing China is a competition where there are four celebrity judges who will select their favorite voices to join their team. All I wanted to just to be known for was that I was a decent singer. I just wanted that validation.
Through the years, we all will be together.
I have been singing for more than a decade before the contest. Compared to other jobs in Singapore, making music is not that, it's not that easy. Yeah, the gig rates have not risen since the 80s. So I think in the 80s, three sets, 150 Singapore dollars. Right now, it's still the same rate at some bars or some restaurants. Completely not expected to make it to the finals of the contest. I never thought I had it in me. So I to this moment, I feel it's so surreal. I can't believe that I'm here. Yeah, shocking.
Some songs from Joanna Dong's So Here I Am concert. It's becoming really real. This concert is a real thing.
I've not done a large scale solo concert ever. So this is like a 1,500 seater at the Esplanade Concert Hall.
I think one of the most dramatic changes is how the public has taken an interest in my career. Instagram, for example, I had maybe 2,000 something followers before the contest. And right now, I think it's gone up all the way to 20K. So for me, that's a really big growth, and I don't think that could ever have happened if I didn't participate in something so widely watched, such as Sing China.
I used to say, nothing will make me step foot in China. I'm eating my own words now. Ha 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 ha. Goes to show, you never know in life things can change. Well, it's always the government's fault. It really is, if not for the government putting the PRCs in front of me. I wouldn't have gotten to know them and want to go to China. So it's still the Singapore government's fault, okay?
In a very simple way, this is a very small country. And I think after living here all my life, I do pine for a bigger space, a bigger country. And China is that kind of a country for me. I went there, I was like, whew, no Singaporean, wonderful. So I don't feel congested. I felt free. I didn't feel I was being observed. Yeah, I think a very good example is that in China, I mean, there are people, like I walked into a bank, a neighborhood bank, and there was this elderly gentleman who looked at me and he went, kumbu, which means horrific, you know? He was referring to my tattoos, but there was no. It was just a description, you know, because I'm a very emotional person, and I get that vibe when people are negative, and I think in Singapore it's completely different because we're so lawful a country. I think people tend to be very presumptuous with their attitude and with their manners and behavior. I come from a very conservative, traditional Chinese family. My grandmother is a direct immigrant from China to Singapore. I was raised as a Cantonese boy, very sheltered, very protected. Even though I know the upbringing, the values and all that, the ethics were very sound and good, but they were too strict, you know? And it didn't allow me to find myself. Although my parents actually wanted to put me in a Chinese school, somehow I ended up in an English school, thank God. So imagine if there's no rock and roll in my life. Oh, I can't imagine that. So anyway, rock and roll was my redemption. Through rock and roll, I found a way out of that strict upbringing, and I found myself eventually, so to speak.
I call him the legend. He's been like my resident customer, so to say, being here most of the time. And mental is most close to him. And something I cannot feed him, he would just come to me. Because,
that's not true.
Yeah, because I always, on behalf, to help him to use whatever he can manage to feed him.
And you know, in China, there is a very vibrant music scene, as you can well imagine. There are all these pockets of indie offerings, alternative culture, you know, pockets of them all over. Like the first time I went there, I was very, very fortunate. It happened to be the last show of a very famous Beijing band named Voodoo Kung Fu. It was their last show because the lead singer was leaving the group. Back then, I could not have imagined this to happen to me. At one time, it was really like, I'm not interested in China. Don't tell me anything about China. Now it's like, yeah, China crazy. I'm China mad. And yeah, I can tell you that the amount of art books that I bought about artists in China, it's made me read up the entire modern history of China. One of my favorite artists in China is a guy called Zhang Huan. I hear that he's now based in Shanghai and he's got a whole factory of his own. But when he started out, he was completely a punk. And maybe that's why I love him, you know? because I come from the whole punk rock music scene in Singapore. So yeah, I really dig Zhang Huan. I've got him tattooed here. Yeah. There!
Besides the subculture in China, mainstream entertainment is gaining popularity and seeing talents flocking over to China for opportunities. My chance new girl watch made in China. We play ping pong ball made in China. Get bitch metal says pain made in China. It had brother black car made in China. She said that she didn't love me. She said that she didn't love me. She said that she didn't love me. She lied, she lied. She all made it in China. She lied, she lied. She all made it in China. She all made it in China. She all made it in China. She lied, she lied.
I teach urban studies at the Yale NUS College in Singapore and also sociology at the National University of Singapore. A lot of the Chinese presence in media is actually through financing. Because sometimes when you look at a film, like a lot of it is now co-production, and often there's two or three Chinese mainland companies, along with Hong Kong companies, along with sometimes foreign, international. So the industry's presence is not just in the product, but also in its ability to finance co-production, so you get that. So, one reason why Canto Pop is disappearing is because even the Cantonese singers are now singing in Mandarin because of the market reach.
For Chinese language productions, movies, music, a lot of it is moving to China. Ever since Sing China competition, I've been releasing a single once every month or so. So I had this single called Shan Shan Dao Fang. So that was something that captured, you know, the essence of how I felt during the Sing China contest. Something about how you wait very long for happiness or for good fortune or for something to come your way. It seems like it takes that long before you acquire enough ability and stability to make it in such a high-stress competition. So, you know, I think the reality is you still have to put in a lot of work. 台下十年功.
Even local television actors and actresses often will leave Singapore to seek new opportunities and new audience. So you see like Zhuanzi and now J.J. Lin continue to be fairly popular.
My dream would be to retire to Thailand, be based out of there, and have the money to travel China, see as much as I can, meet as many people as I can. For me, a place is really not about the scenery, it's about the people.
Yeah, I think China is definitely the main destination for the next few years of my career. I think it is undeniable that the market there is much bigger and it's growing so quickly that you'd be quite silly not to try and enter the market, especially if we're doing Mandarin language music.